3, 2, 1, go.
You're watching Bloomberg Quint Market Wrap. Well, we tell you about all the transparent in the markets in a gist. The Indian benchmark indices, of course, ended on a flat note today, giving up all of its early gains. The small cap index saw a sharper knock of about 0.8%. But for the week, the Nifty has lost about 0.5%. On that note, let's bring in our guest, Mr. A.K. Prabhakar, the head of research at IDBI Capital. Thank you for joining us, sir. So the Nifty has just given or gone nowhere in the last 1 week or so. Do you expect this consolidation trend to continue into the next week as well?
See, it has almost been 3 weeks that Nifty has not moved anywhere. Now, the important thing is every weekend there is some geopolitical activity which is going on, which is impacting the sentiment. Now this week, if nothing happens, I think market can open gap up. So now this consolidation phase is always a possibility in a bull market. From 10,100 odds, we have corrected till 9,600, not more than that. It is a very small correction which we have seen, and market is staying put at around 9,800 levels. So I feel we are in a very mega bull market. And slowly and gradually, once this geopolitical issues subside, the rally should continue. Already we are seeing strong stock performing. If you take NBFC for that matter or a private bank, they are doing very good. It is the weaker stock which is getting hit, mainly in the PSU pack or in power sector, which are taking the hit, or pharma. But if you see the overall market, it is in the bullish trend.
Sure. All right. The Nifty Metal Index, of course, continued with its positive bias for the sixth straight session on the back of higher commodity prices. But it was the pharma and the realty indices which lost to 1.5%. Dr. Reddy's, of course, Saloni fell as much as 7% before recovering quite a bit today.
So talking about the Nifty stocks, let's have a look here. In terms of stock, Mahindra and Mahindra took a biggest hitting today, and it is down about 3.5% ahead of the GST Council meet tomorrow, wherein government is looking to hike cess on SUVs and luxury cars. In terms of Dr. Reddy, as Shraddha was rightly mentioning, it fell to its lowest level in 11 months after German regulator found 6 major observations in its Visakhapatnam unit. Apart from that, you have names like Bharat Petroleum and Sun Pharma also under pressure, down about 2%, a lot of caution in there. Now, talking about gainers, apart from that, the heavyweights like L&T and Bharti Airtel gained in trade today, up and over about 3% today. Maruti Suzuki is up 0.5% as a company is looking at electric vehicle motors. A lot of momentum there. And sir, talking about Nifty stocks, Power Grid has been consolidated in the past 5 days. Are there more legs to this rally, sir?
See, it is corrected exactly 21 trading days from the highest level. 21 is a Fibonacci number, and if you see the fundamental, they have been growing at 20% regularly, and they have a net profit margin of 30%. It is a company which is consistently growing, and there is a AGM on 19th of this month, and there is a dividend payment. So whenever there is a dividend payout, normally the stock doesn't perform. So it is just a consolidation. I'm very bullish on the stock. Once this AGM is over, the stock will start to perform. And if they bring InvIT, then it is going to be a major trigger for them. So for last 8 years, it has been consolidating. Next 3 years can be the best time. I have a target of 350 rupees in the next 3 years horizon. And this is a very safe stock, which quotes at a very low multiple also, PE multiple also.
Fair enough. So Power Grid is, of course, one of the most favorite stock picks, at least in the power sector. You also have Mr. Prabhakar, who is bullish on the stock over the longer term. But Britannia hit its 52-week high today. How is that position?
See, Britannia has been a consistent performer. The fundamentals are also in place, and they are going for expansion, where they are going for a high margin business. They are getting into the premium business where they are expanding. When the stock is showing strength, No, it never corrects much. No, it will correct 5% or 10%. Again, the rally will start. No, we have seen it in Aisha Motor. We have seen it in Maruti. It is a consumption phase where, regularly there is a growth, and technically also there is a lot of strength. And people like to buy quality. And these stocks do not correct in a market like this. And when we are going to have the mega bull rally in the later part of this year, I think these are stocks which will give you very good return. I have a short-term target, 3 to 5 months, 6 months target of 4,750.
All right. Let's also have a quick look at how the broader markets were doing. If you look at the Nifty 500 index, the advance decline ratio deteriorated to 1:2 today after seeing strong sort of numbers over the past few sessions. But when it comes to some of the top losers, you had 8K Miles Software and the likes of DB Realty, which lost more than 6%. Himachal Futuristic was also on the losing end after two straight upper circuits. You had Bajaj Finance, which lost nearly 4% after hitting fresh lifetime highs and touching that market capitalization of 1 lakh crore yesterday. On the gaining side, you had the likes of Colte, Patil and GE Shipping, which rose more than 8% each. JSW Energy was also seeing strong gains on the back of government's push to electric vehicles. JSW Energy, remember, has spoken in the past about its interest in that space. You also, the likes of CCL Products are gaining as much as 6% on higher FI investment limits. Saloni, Manappuram was yet another stock which did well today.
So my next question would be, Manappuram Finance has actually moved to an uncharted territory. It has gained over 3.5% today. How much more gains do you see in the stocks?
See, you have only two companies in the pan-India gold space, gold finance space. Now, and they have almost 59 tons of gold. Now, and the book is almost 41 rupees. Now, and still it is very attractive compared to the other NBFC space. And they have the highest margin, almost 13 to 15% is a margin in gold business, and 19% is the non-gold business. So, they are doing very good. The only problem is their microfinance division, which is not doing very good, but the write-off has been very, particularly it has been very good. And I think from here the turnaround will take. And for a EPS of almost 9.5 rupees, I think the growth is also there in gold finance. So I think this is a wonderful stock. Now I have a target of 130 rupees, by this calendar year end itself, by December.
All right. And Bharat Electricals, on the other hand, is down about 3%. What's your call there, sir?
See, BEL, 41,000 crores is the order book, and you have a new defense minister. So the focus will be on defense. I like even L&T on that basis, Bharat Forge, even Axis Cade. So defense will be a focus area, and with new minister, again, the hopes will start to build. And Bharat Electronics has gone for an expansion plan in Andhra. So once that comes on stream, because there is a capacity constraint for them. So once that comes on stream, I think the volumes will scale up. And the weak quarter, which was June quarter, has been very good for them. So I'm very positive on the stock. If you are looking at 50 to 60% return in the next 1-2 years, BEL, Bharat Electronics is a stock to be in.
All right. And you also have a call on Arvind and Bata, both of course, which are consumption related stocks.
See, consumption is the theme where it is likely to play out. So I think this is not played out well. DMart, the valuation which DMart commands, Arvind or Bata is not commanding. Bata has been almost for 100 years, and they have shifted their mix. They said previously women contribute only 28%, now it is 35%. So I think that mix, if that starts to improve, then the margin also will start to improve. And they are going into the third line and fourth line cities, which is going to be the main trigger. And almost the stock is near all-time high. And if that all-time high breaks, then it is going to give you 20-25% return in next 1 year.
All right, thank you so much for joining us, Mr. Prabhakar. So, Bharat Electronics, Power Grid, Manappuram, Britannia, some of recommendations that are coming from him. But that was all from us on BQ Market Wrap. For more updates, you can always log on to bloombergquint.com. But till then, see you and have a good weekend.